So my piece of music's got a very imaginative title. It's called Piano Sonata Number 1. Basically, I have a couple of lessons with Michael Finnessy in preparation for this piece, which I started about 2 years ago or so. And Michael said, don't call it Piano Sonata 1, whatever you do. So I obviously had to call it Piano Sonata Number 1. I'm sorry, Michael. But that doesn't mean it's not programmatic or it's not got a number of different influences. One of the influences is I was reading a book called 101 Things I Learned in Architecture School, which is an amazing little book that's kind of given out to students of architecture and kind of details things that they have to know or should know, kind of interesting little tidbits. And one of those pages describes light and windows. It describes how if a room has got a window facing one of the four compass points, the room will kind of be imbued with a different quality or a different feel as a result of that light. So if I remember correctly, light coming from a north-facing window will be kind of dark and grey for the entire day, whilst one from a different compass point will kind of grow in light and get almost overbearing before dying away towards the end of the day. So I wrote my piece of music in four movements based upon those four compass points, those four different kinds of light. But also, I kind of started thinking for each movement specific rooms as well. So I decided to write about a room that I lived in, a room from fiction, a room in a place which used to exist but doesn't anymore, and a room that I kind of made up entirely. And those are the four movements. Has already been played before by Chris, and that was about 2 years ago. And then I've kind of written the other three movements within the space of 2 years or so, and kind of like these really intense little chunks. So I'll write a movement, and then I'll move on to another piece, and then come back to this piece and write another movement, and that's kind of how it works. There are themes. There's broad programmatic themes like the theme of light and the theme of windows, architecture and space. And of fiction and fact, and it's kind of connected in those kind of slightly less tangible ways. But in strictly musical terms, yeah, I mean, probably a bit old-fashioned now, but I constructed a tone room that features throughout and is used to derive an awful lot of the material. Back when I was doing my undergrad, I met and studied with a composer called Piers Tattersall. And Piers and Chris are in an ensemble together, the Edison Ensemble. And so I kind of met Chris through Piers and through the Edison Ensemble, and then performed a few of my pieces before. The other thing I really like about the Borough New Music Series is you seem to put on a tremendous amount of concerts in a really short space of time, which is great. There's nothing worse than having a concert series where you get a concert once every 3 years or something. This works really well.